Hello. Die Erkan. Staatssekretär, mein Vater arbeitet während der Firma nähert sich erfahren 20 Jahren. Die Fernando die Tochter einer Flotte, keinen Straße, der steht London Verkäufer. Secretary State, mein Vater worked for a company approaching some 50 years. Fernando I like daughter of a Fleet Street. Not the street, near street, London, Salman. The Earl came. You want to buy a tenant. So often you keep speaking about it. Have it considered all things are possible. But have you considered the people who make a mistake in what they purchase? How do you consider the mistakes that are made? These can be measured by the hours beyond the day. Those hours that shall pretend to dream. But there is a difference in the mind of the artist to the mind of the so-called reality of the day-to-day life of the person who is not artistically thinking at all. How will this affect your piano choice if you are not thinking artistically? I'll tell you how it is. There were two composers. They both decided to work in cohesion, both to write the same song. And they would go into different rooms and they would put their ideas on paper. They would try and construct what they thought the other person was writing. Perhaps you have seen, have you, that television program which is entitled After the Idea of the Sixth Sense. And it was introduced by Colin Fry, the psychic medium. If you have seen or you think you have heard those who you love calling you and telling you what to do, those ideas which govern our lives early are escaping us forever, by hook or by crook at some stage. Has it occurred to you how important it is not to remember the present? Now that may seem ridiculous to any one of you, but the option is, for instance, me to have said to you, the importance is to remember the past. But if I had said that, your instinct would automatically make you want to forget it. Because psychologically, your free will tells you that you will not be told what to do. These two players, these two writers, in separate rooms, composing what the other they thought was writing. I give you an example on my video, my film, my pianoforte, of Eleanor Rigby by Paul McCartney and John Lennon, which was laid down on the 5th of August 1966. And the music of Franz Schubert, known as the Earl King. Both compositions are apart by approximately 160 years, in the sense that should but have written. It's music. That distance apart. But in effect, the distance is much longer. That was created in the poem by Johann Wolfgang von Goethe, called Earl Tonic, which literally is Earl King. And it depicts the death of a child assailed by a supernatural being. If you have studied Eleanor Rigby, you will know that both are in the same key, because they both effectively start on the same chord. If you have not a piano, but you are used to playing the guitar, as indeed Mr. McCartney might be deemed to fall into which category, you would establish, wouldn't you, that the idea of chord is a basic length to the tone which the notes of melody are going to be given above or below, more easily defined on a piano. In the case of the Earl King, so easily seen, where the tune is in the bass, it's in the left hand, as it were. And this, in terms of its rank and its key, is a deciding factor in that chord as to the kind of melody that you will be able to write on your piano. Perhaps it is essential, is it, that you do not see certain guitars that look a certain way, because they will affect your interpretation of your intent to which you will strum the chord. It is this kind of thing which makes her piano so different to anyone else's. Have you looked at my pianos? Do you notice why they are different? And then, irrespective of whether you have made a decision or not, have you listened to how the music is the same as some other fellows? Or have you deduced, or will you deduce, that it is any way different, and if so, how? Eleanor, in Eleanor Rigby, is pronounced very simply as Eleanor Rigby, written on a gravestone. Yet that kind of result was not originally chosen by Mr. McCartney, who had instead at one stage deemed that it was going to be written in accordance with the name Hawkins. Eleanor Rigby tells the story of, not difficult, is it, to understand, a person who is perceived through the eyes of people which you cannot recognize. How much is life decided by how much we recognize what we are seeing, and how much we dream about how we will change it, is essential in your choice of piano. The song which continued in its transformation of the Beatles from a mainly rock and roll pop-oriented act to a more experimental, thus studio-based band with a double string quartet, an arrangement by George Martin with a striking lyrics about loneliness. That idea that you can perceive what the person in the other room is writing was in fact, in part, the facts pertaining to the case of Mr. John Lennon and Mr. Paul McCartney composing a song for the Beatles. I was sitting at the piano when I thought of it. The first few bars just came to me and I got this name in my head. Daisy Hawkins picks up the rice in the church. I do not know why, I couldn't think of much more, so I put it away for a day. Then the name Father McCartney came to me and all the lonely people, but I thought that people would think it was supposed to be about my dad sitting knitting his socks. That's the happy lad, so I went through the telephone book and I got the name Mackenzie. So, how important is it to assume the item that you are buying? I mean, not to think or to assert, but to make the item that you are buying fit what you want to achieve. These two composers in separate rooms were not named Lennon and McCartney. These two composers in separate rooms were trying to reconstruct the string quartet apart from Eleanor Rigby, not the one that Mr. George Martin composed, but they were trying to construct a string quartet to the tune of a tune by Haydn. When it came that they came, they left the rooms. It was discovered that there was little or no resemblance to the harmonies and the simulation of the kind of effects which Haydn had composed and the one that the two in the rooms had attempted. And there were, in a sense, a much different reality between the two in separate rooms compared to each other. So did you see that if you want to choose the name Hawkins, it will have an effect on you. But in this respect, the name of any piano, this explains to you, cannot be used in any way to assert any success that you will have in playing, whether you call the piano after some great, magnificent singing star, or whether the piano is called over some long-forgotten inventor, such as, for instance, a hall piano. There isn't one, is there, called a hall piano, after Edwin Hall, who designed and worked on magnetic fields. But Lennon was quoted in 1971 as having said that he wrote a good half of the lyrics or more. So what is the truth of that? Is the truth or more that he said? Or is it that he wrote a good half, meaning less than a half? And in the 1980s he claimed that he wrote all but the first verse. But Chapman, who was Lennon's childhood friend, remembered Lennon's contribution as being absolutely nil. McCartney said that John helped me on a few words, but I put down 80 to 20 to me. Something like that. I mean, if you refer anything to the past, it can have little evidence always as proof. And this is the point about why. You cannot, in many ways, unless you are an artist, unless you have already, as it were, composed the Eleanor Rigby, or you have written the string quartet using the piano keyboard, it is almost impossible, if you have no knowledge of music and no knowledge of piano manufacture or make, to choose the right instrument. And yet any one of you is choosing by price and by bid. Does that explain to any one of you why so many people fail? So many people will tell you, oh, we learned the piano 40 years ago, but we gave up. That's the reason why I do it. I suppose there is, in one sense, a pathos in the fact, or a pathology, if you quote the word by title of the composition, which I laid down on the piano with the electric keyboard you see in the film. There is pathos in the fact that you will, by any misadventures into the world of purchasing instruments to either compose or to play, bear in mind that when you play, you are in fact composing. Because whether you are writing anything of your own onto the piano, or whether you are repeating something that somebody else has written or played, it can never sound exactly the same. So that may seem obvious to any one of you, but I can assure you, it is not obvious, or it is more than obvious, to the listener, who will heed it more than maybe so many buyers do themselves. If we take the fact that you will make your mistakes and you will be able to correct them, then we have to look at the fact that, in truth, some people will not. Who are those people? They can be deemed to be all the lonely people who have said at some stage or other, we had the chance of learning, but I didn't practice enough. Those people wanted to go on the stage. They said, well, I could never really remember my lines. You know, there is a point, isn't there, at which we give up being ourselves, or a point at which, as in the song, Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice in the church where Redding has been, lives in a green, waits at the window, wearing the face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? That all the lonely people, where do they all come from, has the question mark. But the previous line, which I just quoted, that she keeps in a jar by the door, who is it for? The keeps in a jar by the door, who is it for, does not have any question mark. Does that suggest that it is not asking you something, viewer, but it is telling you something? So what it might be telling you is any number of things which you might think about. But the most obvious one, isn't it, is that it is telling you that it is for you that she keeps the face in a jar by the door. That it is for you, because how often have you been to take a jar off of a shelf or to look through a window and more been acquainted by acquainting that image, not which is someone else, but in you, mirrored in a slight reflection by not so much parallax, but more by reflection, pure and simple. But reflections can lie, as much as the past can lie. Oh, look at the lonely people, look at the lonely people. All the lonely people, where do they come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? It is said by the accounts given of the Beatles that Paul certainly stated that he achieved its first invention by creating it through a Miss Sadie Hawkins. But then there is the reflection that the meeting with John Lennon in 1957 was in an area where it was not only the area of the place that effectively was a fete. At the first met at the Walton Village Garden fete in the afternoon of the 6th of July 1957, it contained still the gravestone of an individual called Eleanor Rigby, and McCartney, Paul, has conceded he may not have been subconsciously influenced by the name on the gravestone. The real Eleanor Rigby lived a lonely life similar to that woman in the song. But apart from all that and all the stories of John Lennon and George Harrison, Kenley, and John Lennon at Kenwood, London, their finest, their friend Peter Shotton, all listened to this Paul playing song, contributed the ideas. Harrison came up with the idea, ah, look at all the lonely people, yeah, look, star. Contributed the line, writing the words of a sermon that no one will hear, and suggested Father McCartney, darned socks, that Mr. McCartney at one stage admitted that he was not thinking that it was a good idea that his own father should be mentioned in the song. That in case the listener mistook the fictional character in the song for Mr. McCartney's own father as being, as it were, real life. The song is often described as a lament for the lonely people. So we have to deduce why you are choosing a piano that is going to perform something which you are going to play, which is going to depict exactly the finer aspects of your imagination, of the music that you will write yourself, or the finest examples of attribution, pure and simple, as hard as it may be to detect, as to how the original composer actually intended their own music for you to play. And what, therefore, proof do you have as to what the composer wanted is given by two main things. One is the words which they wrote to a particular song, which in the case of the Earl King by Schubert, was the words by the poet Goethe, which were laid down in approximately 1797, which is more than 160 years before the Beatles' Eleanor Rigby song. If you take the two equations of destiny or sixth sense in relation to the two rooms where two composers write what they purport to be on the same song, to the same aim to compose an accompaniment for it, the fact was that the string quartet itself was not composed by Mr. McCartney or Mr. John Lennon in the rooms at all. It was composed by Mr. George Martin, the string quartet. But what is the text of the Earl King? And I tell you, basically, it's German translation. I'll read it very quickly to you. Who rides so late through the night in Wellington, the father with his child, he has the boy well in his arm. He hold him safely, he keep him warm. My son, why you hide your face and fear, father, you do not see the Elf King. Elf King with crown and cape, my son is in a streak of fog. You, dear child, come with me. Very beautiful games I play with you. Many a coloured flower is on the beach. My mother has a golden robe. The son is telling him that he sees his mother with a golden robe. You, dear child, come go, and I play with you. Many a flower is on the beach. My father, the son is calling. And here's, do you not, what is the Elf King quietly promises me. Be calm, stay calm, my child, the father said. Soon, scrawny leaves as wind is fine. You fine boy want to go with me, my daughter shall wait on you, finally. My daughters lead the nightly dance, and rock the dance, and sing, and bring you in. But the son says, my father sees you there, and is still going, ba da 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 da. The Elf King's daughter's in the gloomy place. And then it slows right up.
The Elf King.
Bereitet durch Nacht und die Wind, es ist in Faden nicht einer hat den Abend.
What they call in Italian terms, Rallentender. My son, I see it clearly. There shimmering the old willows to the grey. I love you, your beautiful form entices me. But this Wellentender viewer is in the fact that the father is not perceiving what is actually the child is telling him. My father, he's touching me now. The Elf King has done me harm. It horrifies the father, he swiftly rides on. And this is actually what Goethe is saying. It horrifies the father. He holds the moaning child in his arms. And there's real rallentando now in the music, which is not any longer going da 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 da, reaches the farm with great difficulty. In his arms the child is dead. And this is set, you can imagine, to the sadness, very simply, so you all understand it, of a minor key. Would it surprise you to know the lyric to Eleanor Rigby by Mr. McCartney, whether it is 20 or 80% of what Mr. Lennon claimed he had largely written, or a majority, or a less majority, is also in a similar of the exact key. But it is certainly in a minor key, and it also contrasts the major relative keys to it, which, without going into a lot of examples, is the key of C major and G major, in the home key, to which is the home key of E minor. Just a lyric to Eleanor Rigby, recorded and released on the 5th of August 1966. I read it very quickly, viewer. Ah, look at all the lonely people, and this is where the strings are scraping away. Eleanor Rigby picks up a rice in the church where a wedding has been lived in the green wet. By the window where her face that she keeps in the jar, by the door, who is it for? All the lonely people, where do they come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Father Mackenzie writing the words of a sermon that no one will hear, no one comes near. Look at him working, darning his socks in the night where there's nobody there, who doesn't care? All the lonely people, where do they come from? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? Oh, look at the lonely people, look at the lonely people. Eleanor Rigby died in the church and was buried along with her name. Nobody came. Father Mackenzie, not Miss McCartney's wife, husband, or son-in-law, or anything else, but Father Mackenzie, a name he had made up. Why? Here we go. Wiping the dirt from his hands as he walked from the grave, no one was saved. People, where do they come from? All the lonely people, where do they belong? Songwriters, Lennon, John, McCartney, Paul. Eleanor Rigby lyrics. Copyright, Sunny, ATV Music Publishing. In brief, viewer, you may study the parable of the Good Samaritan, and you will see that they both have the same emphasis on the fact that when Jesus was asked what should inherit in terms of charity, but to do unto others as in the way that the man who fell amongst these, I thank you for listening, but this is not a Levite or a Jew. I am a humble musician. The Earl King. Yeah, okay.